This is Ian from Elara, and in this tutorial, we will focus on deploying to the Oculus Go VR headset from UE4. You'll need a recent version of UE4. I'll dive into the Epic Games launcher and download 4.19. Oculus Go is an Android device, so navigate to your engine's extras directory and run the Android Works installer to install all of the prerequisites. Keep the default settings and add API 21. This version is the minimum version that Oculus accepts on the online store. Android Works also installs the Android Debug Bridge, ADB for short. Unselect Insight Tegra if prompted. You'll need to accept the terms and conditions in order to continue. Once the download is complete, you'll need to restart your computer. In the meantime, grab the mobile device you intend to pair with Oculus Go. Install the Oculus app from your App Store and follow the initial device setup if you haven't already. Then, enable developer mode in the More Settings panel of your paired Go headset. Connect your Go to your PC via the USB cable and open a command prompt window. Type ADB devices and hit enter. Your headset will probably show as unrecognized. Solve this by holding the headset up to your face while it is still USB connected. Check the checkbox and hit OK. Then, run ADB devices on your computer once more. Let's set up a simple UE4 project to deploy to the Go. Start by saving the map and opening your project settings. Start off by giving your project a name and enabling Start in VR. We'll want our project to default to the main map, so update the default maps in the Maps and Modes section. The Go has no touch screen, so remove the default touch interface in the Input section. In the Rendering section, enable Multi-Sample Anti-Aliasing, Forward Shading, and Instance Stereo. In the Android section, press the Configure Now button, then accept the SDK license if you haven't already. Take a moment to replace your company, then update the minimum SDK version and target SDK version to 21. Enable Full Screen Immersion on KitKat and above devices, and swap support OpenGL to ES 3.1. Configure the Android manifest for deployment to Gear VR. Restart your project to apply changes, and we'll move on to setting up a simple stereoscopic scene. Delete everything from the map except for the player start, and add a sphere static mesh actor with a scale of 400. Now, we'll prepare the material for the sphere. In the Materials Detail panel, enable two-sided and set shading model to unlit. We'll be viewing it from the inside and only need an emissive channel. Plug a texture sample node into the emissive color channel. If you don't have a Stereo 360 image of your own, you'll be able to download one from the link in the description of this tutorial. The top portion of the image will serve as our left eye, and the bottom as our right eye. We'll map the UVs of the left eye first. Do this by getting the texture coordinates node and setting V tiling to 0.5. in the New Nodes Detail panel. For the right eye, use an Add node after the existing coordinate with a constant 2 vector of 0 and 0.5. We can choose between these two UV options with a Lerp node, using a 0 or 1 alpha to display the left or right eye. Add a custom node with the Float 1 output type. In the Code section, type return resolved view dot stereo pass index, followed by a semicolon. The texture appears inverted inside the sphere. To fix this, we'll negate its scale on the x-axis. You should see the Go as an Android device in the launch dropdown. Click it to deploy to your Go. Once the project has deployed and it shows as running on your device, unplug the Go and take a look. The distortion you see here is due to my camera's refresh rate. In the headset, it should be running smoothly. Thank you for joining us here at Elara. We produced a tutorial for modeling the Oculus Go hand controller, so be sure to check that out and download the free model. I've added a download link for this UE4 project in the description below. Also, please check out Elara on the web and reach out if you'd like to join the Elara team.